Well, growing up, did you ever fight with your brothers and sisters over the bathroom or maybe the remote control? We'll spare a thought for our next guest and her 150 siblings.
Yeah, that's right. Mary Jayne Blackmore was raised in a fundamentalist Mormon family in the town of Bountiful in Canada. Her father married 27 times, and she has, you heard it right, 150 brothers and sisters. She joins us now to tell us all about it. Mary Jayne, good to meet you.
Hi.
Thanks for talking to us today. Your mother, Jayne, was your father's first wife. And as he married again and again and your family grew, what is day-to-day life like as one of 150 kids?
For us, it was normal. We lived a rural farm lifestyle. And it was big family dinners. We went to our independent school in our community, and my mom, several of the moms were teachers. We all played music, piano, we'd sing a lot. We worked on farm chores, and it was fairly idealistic, riding ponies and having pet lambs. My mom's flower gardens were a big part of our life. And of course, you can see our mothers were brilliant seamstresses, sewed our clothes.
So you had 26 mothers, is that right? Did you call them mum?
Yeah, mostly, yeah. My dad married three widows later in life, and we were an interesting family. I credit the mothers a lot for the home life, creating a safe and welcoming space for us, for the children. And for the most part, I felt welcome and nurtured and safe as a child.
Mm. Well, you'll most definitely be busy as well. You weren't allowed TV or modern music. You weren't even allowed to drink tea or coffee. How did you, you had a farm life there. Is that how you spent most of your time out of school?
We grew big gardens in the summer, and we had a pond on our property. So we would ride our horses over to the pond and go swimming for the afternoon after our chores were done, of course. And, Mormon kids worked pretty hard, so we'd get up early and weed the corn patch and take care of the chores, mow the grass, that sort of thing. And then usually had our afternoons free to do climb the mountain and ride our ponies, stuff like that.
Oh, wow.
Polygamy is illegal in many countries, including in Canada, where you grew up. So can you explain to us, help us understand why your dad did take 27 wives? What was the motivation behind that?
It was such an important part of the faith. And for my dad, he certainly has lived his faith. And that's one thing I've watched consistently throughout his life. I no longer call myself a Mormon. I still live in the community and I teach school here, but polygamy was part of the Mormon culture since its founding. And when many Mormons moved to Canada, it was to seek refuge for their faith and to keep practicing polygamy when it was made illegal in the United States, when Utah became a state in the United States.
Right. Now, you were taught as Mormons that the end of the world was coming. What did you think was actually going to happen? And did it frighten you as a child?
We believed in the end of times wholeheartedly. It's a prophecy that's been part of the faith forever, I think. And it was, especially around the year 2000, we were preppers, like for real preppers. And we believed and were taught that God would send fire from heaven and destroy the wicked off the face of the earth. And this was very real to us. And yes, for many, that was pretty terrifying to imagine.
equally, people would say that having a husband chosen for you when you're a teenager is pretty terrifying, and that happened to you. How did you feel about that, and did the marriage work?
Yeah, it was normalized as part of the culture, so I certainly felt prepared mentally for this big step in my life, and I think I felt pretty confident that the prophet would look out for me, I guess, because I don't remember feeling that scared of it. And it was important in the faith, like in the Mormon church, women don't hold the priesthood. So you need to be married to a priesthood man. That's a part of the faith. And so getting married was a normal step that we would take. It became more urgent around the year 2000 when I married, because the end of times were close. So there was this trend towards younger marriage and this like ever urgent feeling of the end of times are coming. And this was what I've witnessed as a big reason that my family exists the way it does, is many women and families wanted their daughters to be married to a good man, a righteous man. And my father was seen as a very good man. So many fathers were encouraging their daughters to marry him, and many, what I saw, women, young women that wanted to marry into his family. And, wow.
Are you still married, so, Mary Jayne? Are you still married?
I'm not, no. Our marriage lasted for 10 years. And I consider that a successful marriage. We raised two children. We had two children in the marriage, and we were happy. I think it was a good marriage, and I feel grateful to have had that experience. I feel that we grew out of our marriage. Mm-hmm.
And you mentioned before that you don't call yourself you don't call yourself a Mormon anymore, but you've written extensively in your new memoir, Balancing Bountiful, What I Learned About Feminism from My Polygamist Grandmothers, about the faith that you were brought up with, but also about your about the women in your life. What did they teach you about feminism?
It's interesting because we lived in a very cohesive, we still do live in a cohesive community, and that's evolved over the time. But specifically when I was young, the women really did run the community, and mostly our fathers, who were the leaders in the church, they worked away. And so the daily lives were really run by women. And I was raised by strong women who really had strong voices and were powerful leaders in their own right. And yeah, I feel like that has influenced me a lot in the way I carry myself as a woman in the modern world and expect to be seen and heard.
Well, great. Well, so you will be heard now. Yeah, Mary Jayne Blackmore's memoir is called Balancing Bountiful, What I Learned About Feminism from My Polygamist Grandmothers. Mary Jayne, thanks so much for joining us today. And hopefully now you're living a happy life.
Incredible story.
Thank you. Thank you for your time and your interest.